Hey everyone.
Hey guys.
Hi. This episode of Aussie Garage, we are heading out to a little town called Kulin out in the middle of nowhere, about 3 hours out of Perth. We decided we want to get out to the bush and see what's hiding out here in people's garages. We'd get out of our normal playing ground. So
Absolutely. Yeah. Yep. We've
got Dan out here. You saw Dan on the tuning Phil's XC. Yep. So he's out here. He's gathered a few people together for us to come and talk to and see and interview and look at their cars. So we don't really know what we're looking at yet. We haven't really got a list of cars that are going to be there. So
as long as it's like vintage muscle or even a wreck or a rusty bloody piece of gold, I'm happy.
Yeah, that's it. Anyway, we'll stay tuned and we'll see what we find. I don't get it. What the hell are you doing all the way out here on a bloody push bike? Without no idea. Alright, 50 zone. That usually means something.
That means we're in Kulin.
Where is Kulin? Hello, Kulin. Where are you? Well, there's some houses over there.
Yeah, there are.
Yeah, a little micro community out in the bush. It's what we were looking for, really, isn't it?
Absolutely.
What was that? What did you say?
Oh, nothing.
What
did you say? I said nothing.
Wait, what was that, mate?
Nothing.
I'm going to leave that in there because I want the people to hassle you.
Don't worry, I'm hassling myself as it is.
Cool. Oh, what have you got here? Corrugated iron kangaroo.
Yep. Oh, not this one.
Some corrugated iron sheep.
A lot of those drum art. We've seen them everywhere.
Oh, yes. Oh, he's painting.
Awesome.
Painting a portrait, or a landscape, sorry. Oh, look at that old truck there. We'll have to come and look there.
Perfect, yeah. Oh, there's a Valiant there too.
Oh, a Pacer. Look at that. I can't zoom in, but there's a Pacer down there. Well, there's Pete's one tyre, so it's still there.
Yeah, we've still got that, so perfect.
All right, let's go see if we can find some people.
Sounds like a plan. All right, it's Phil here from Aussie Garage. I'm here with Gerald. Gerald, tell us about this car, mate. What is it?
Well, it's a 1969 two-door hardtop.
Yep.
Valiant. We actually rescued it, bought it off my cousin. It was under a tree with water in the motor, no bonnet.
Yep.
And I've got three boys, and I thought, well, I'll take it home. Took it home for $50 and said to the boys, I'm only a bush mechanic, but we'll get the head off it and get the water out of the sump and get it rolling. So we did that.
Yep.
And we drove it around for a while and they had a bit of fun with it and it wouldn't start after a while. So they discarded it. And I looked at it one day after our Kulin charity rally started and I thought that old girl might be okay.
Yep.
So, decided to get it licensed. So I went and saw the local engineer bloke and he said, well, what you've got to do is make sure that everything that worked on it when it was new still works.
Yep.
So I did that, got it all up and running, got it licensed, and she's done 23 old bastards charity rallies now.
Oh, well, perfect.
And it's given us a little bit of trouble, but it's never failed to finish.
Well, that's the main thing. That's the main thing.
So she's raised a bit of money for the hospitals and the RFDS, and was meant to go again this year, but we didn't have enough cars, so it was cancelled. But hopefully it runs next year.
Okay, awesome. Yeah. We see like all the stickers down the side of the car and everything for these people obviously supporting you with this, well, this kind of run.
Well, these are our sponsors, but half of them are missing because I didn't get it up and tidied up for this year.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So I even took a couple off. Liberty Fuel came off this morning because it was going to blow off.
Yep.
So, but yeah, they're our sponsors and that just sort of stays on there from year to year. And if they get a bit tatty, we put new ones on.
Yeah, awesome.
Yeah.
So we were talking about this earlier, like, you know, I thought this was a Pacer, but it's not a Pacer, but it looks quite similar.
Well, I don't think, I did look it up one day, there's a few markings on the dashboard and the glove box and a couple of other things that distinguish them as a Pacer.
Yes.
But very, and I think the dashboard instruments are quite a bit different.
Yep.
But yeah, I'd venture to say probably not a lot of difference other than that, but no, it's not a Pacer.
Yep.
Yeah, 69 two-door hardtop.
No, perfect little ride. And what have you got underneath the hood at the moment?
There's just a straight six, 245.
Okay.
Before I bought it, before I got it,
yep.
It had a automatic in it.
Okay.
Column shift automatic.
Yep.
But some budding mechanic put a three-speed manual in it, and that's what's in it today.
Well, if it works, it works.
The two blokes, well, it does still work, which is a little bit surprising because the two blokes that I take with me every year, Donald Bradford and Norm Quick, they've tried to destroy it because it's got first gear lines up with reverse and then you shift over to the right for second and third, and they've had it in all sorts of positions, but it still operates correctly. So I think it shifts into gear a bit easier these days because I reckon they've rounded the cogs off and it just slips in and out of gear.
Yeah, that makes life easier, doesn't
it? But they can't destroy it.
Yep.
Kevin, no.
Nah. But look, she's a perfect ride. I love these old girls and stuff like that. I mean, have you got any other plans for the future besides keep doing the runs with it? Or
No real plans. It's a bit untidy body-wise. Mechanically, it's very good. Tony Beggs, who used to run the wrecker's yard here, he put a set of rings and bearings in it for me years ago.
Yep.
Because he used to get a bit of engine fumes in the cab, and my two offsiders reckon I should do something about it, so we did.
Yep.
So now it doesn't use any oil. Put a $1,000 radiator in it the other day, and then they cancelled the rally, so but now it's got a good radiator.
Well, at least but you're not going to overheat, so...
No, it won't overheat. Yep. But no, I haven't actually got any plans for it. I use it a little bit, but doesn't do much other than the rally.
Yeah, yeah, fair enough.
But it serves its purpose there. It gives the RFDS a bit of money.
Yeah, yeah. And that's what you need to do, isn't it?
Yeah.
You
know,
anything's good for charity.
And it's good fun. Yeah.
Why not? Why not?
Yep.
Awesome. And now you've also got this other vehicle over here, which is a...
1965 Chevy Bel Air.
Bel Air. Yep.
Yep.
Nice. So how long have you had this vehicle for?
Well, that one came, a mate of mine, Greg Tiley, found that for me in Narrambeen.
Yep.
A chap called Merv Trelaw owned it, and he was, his mum and dad were the original owners.
Okay.
Mrs. Trelaw took it to town one day to trade it in on a Kingswood, Holden.
Yep.
And when she came home after doing the deal, Merv said to her, "How'd you go, Mum? Did you get good money for it?" She said, "They wouldn't give me anything for it." So I bought the new car, and she said, "I thought you might like the old Chev."
Yeah, yeah, fair enough.
So he wanted to pull a horse float with it for one of his daughters. So he had the motor done up at Chev Power, I think, did the motor up. It's only done 130,000-odd miles.
Oh, wow, that's good.
So now it's in good nick. I think the motor was done up when it had done about 115.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm really only the second owner.
Oh, perfect. Yeah. Perfect. Well, she's in very straight nick.
Well, I do use it on the road, and that's why I've got it fully licensed. It wasn't licensed when I got it, so I had to do a bit of work on it to get it up and running, a bit of suspension work.
Yep.
Had a little bit of rust in it. The top of the boot had rusted out the back window. It was parked in a shed, but facing the south.
Okay,
so the water came in and it rusted out between the back window and the roof.
Yep.
Of the boot. So I had all that fixed, and a couple of little holes in the quarter fenders, about as big as 50 cents.
Yep.
Had them repaired. A chap called Brian Drinkwell used to be here, very, very good panel beater. And they fixed it up for me. Lad Mr. Drake up the road, I can't think of his first name, he helped him. So yeah, that's pretty solid, no rust in it. And second owner, It's got a 283 V8 in it.
Yep, awesome.
Original Rochester twin jet carburetor.
Perfect.
Runs like a clock, yeah.
Well, look, it sounds nice when we heard it running. And like I said, it's a perfect little bloody ride, mate. Bit of a pain to park, given the fact that it's so huge, but I suppose you get used to it after a while.
Well, it's a bit like parking your truck. You just pick your spot to park it, and it's easy.
Yeah, fair enough then. Yeah, absolutely.
But no, it's good. It's got good power steering, and yep. I don't take it to the city or anything, so the parking's only in the bush.
And the interior is still all the original interior. You haven't done anything with it at all.
I have done. I think I've reupholstered the bottom of the front seat,
okay,
and all of the back seat.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
So the back of the front seat still smells like Grandpa's car, the old leather.
Yeah, yeah.
In the sun, they always got their distinctive smell.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But it's a work in progress. But I actually like it as it is. It's got some dents in it; would be nice to take out.
Yeah, yeah.
But being such a solid car, yeah, it's. To fix those dents up would make it look nice, and I think that's probably what I'll probably hone in on for the next sort of few years.
Okay.
Just get those little spots fixed up so it looks a bit straighter.
Yeah, fair
enough.
Not
like this old girl. She's got quite a few dents in it.
But this has got character, doesn't it? So.
Well, it has got character, yeah.
You want to keep the character in there, so that's the main thing.
Yeah.
And, once you fix up those little few little dings and stuff like that you're talking about, this thing would come up beautiful, resprayed and everything else.
It would be good, yeah.
You know?
Yeah. It's a bit two-tone now because they've put a bit of paint on it when they had it repaired.
Yep.
And they did the sills for me. They painted them. There was nothing wrong with them, fortunately.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, it's a bit of a work in progress. All good fun. And
well, aren't most projects when you get them anyway? They're all a working project. It just depends on how long that progress goes for.
Yeah, well, my boys, I've got three boys and a girl, and the two boys that are home farming reckon I've got too many projects. And in actual fact, they're right. But who can be the judge of that? I can sleep at night. If my alarm clock didn't wake me up, I'd miss lunch, I reckon.
Yep, fair enough, mate. Fair enough. Well, look, mate, look, we really appreciate you talking to us here at Aussie Garage.
Yeah, not a problem.
Thanks for coming out and seeing us. And look, mate, I love the rides. Love what you're doing with the charity work. It's just perfect.
Yeah, thank you, mate.
Awesome. Appreciate it, buddy.
Yeah, thanks for you blokes coming out as well.
You don't see many of these around anyway.
Hadn't been going for 6 or 8 or 10 years and fixed the fuel cap on them, so you said it started up like a
mutant. Yep. It's just got a bit of a leak at the moment, but.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
Come on, dude. Yeah. We don't have any gear, don't
we? Yeah, yep. Well, you get a workout with these things, wouldn't you?
You fired beautifully.
Yeah. I thought it would have kept going, actually.
Nice.
quite an alright sculpting actually, but in here.
How you going, guys? It's Phil from Aussie Garage. I'm here with Dave and his Mollet Ford. Tell us about it, mate. What do you know about this ride?
1928 model.
Yep. Awesome. And how long have you had this one for?
Oh, probably 20 years.
Wow, okay. Yep.
But I haven't got around to restoring it yet. But no, I hope to sometime or other.
Yeah, we just heard it run and like sounds
that's
awesome
right. Yeah,
for
no,
an old bloody
yeah,
old girl. She sounds good.
Yep, definitely.
Absolutely. Now, and with this, did you buy her from a friend or do you know the history on it or not much?
No, I don't know really know a lot of history. It was a, it came from Yellowing originally, apparently.
Oh, okay, yeah.
That's about all I can tell you.
Yeah, nah, fair enough.
And it went through quite a few people's hands.
Yeah, yep. So you could be about maybe 500 or 600 or
that's
maybe
right,
more.
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
Okay. Well, look, she sounds great, and
it
look,
does.
She's in good nick for like how the age she is.
That's a 1928 model.
Yeah.
Ford A.
Absolutely. It's like fantastic. And when you restore her, you're going to take her right back to full spec if
yeah,
you get
yeah,
around
just
to it.
Original.
And,
yeah.
Yep.
That's
perfect.
How I'm going to do it. So.
Yeah, no, not a problem. And this is the only car that you own at the moment, or you own others?
My brother owns that one there.
Oh, okay, yep. Yeah. Old pickup truck? Yep.
That's right.
Nah, nice. No, I like the
yeah,
old sea cabs.
He's not here, so he can't give you a lot of info about it.
Yeah, that's not a problem at all. Well, look, mate, look, thanks for showing this ride to us. It's
that's
perfect.
Okay.
Love it.
Yep, no worries.
All good. Have a good day, mate.
Yeah, you too.
You too, mate.
Yeah, nice meeting you.
Yeah, you too, mate. You okay. Too.
Instructions from my dear wife of 54 years or something, I'm not allowed to wear my hat. Come on, would you?
The sun's going to be in your eyes, right?
Yeah. Who cares? She came in this morning and she tidied up the hair and cut and pulled the hair out of it.